Okay, so this class is going to be a 4960 class introduction about software and computational engineering. So one key sentence for this class is that why we construct robust and verifiable software to interface with the physical world described by mathematical laws. I use this figure to illustrate the real world is represented by mathematical model. Then you come up with a computational model, and then you have a computer implementation. Okay, and how we'll be able to do this computer implementations, and more importantly, how to test it, how to verify it. Okay, will be the key topic that we'll treat in this semester. The main applications for this class, in addition to the conventional scientific and engineering problems. Think about if you like to have a virtual reality or augmented reality, which I show using this figure, that you immerse in the physical world. The physical world, every item have their identity, every item have their behavior according to mathematical laws, okay, physical laws, okay? And then you present all this reality inside the computer so that the user can emerge and operate on those in that environment. And this will be a program like augmented reality, a program that will be introduced in this class. Okay, how you will be able to write something to interface with the real world and be able to test and verify what you do is correct. Okay. On the programming language, actually, there are two domains. One type of language is fast prototyping, things like Python or MATLAB for math prototyping, or BASIC for microcontroller prototyping. There's something that optimized for hardware-aware programming that lets you to have the exact handles of the memory so the execution can be most efficient. Okay. In this class, I won't constrain about what platform, language, or OS that you will use. Okay. I actually will welcome all kinds of implementations that so that we can compare how different platforms will write the to represent the real world. Okay, so you can feel free to choose your OS, language, or the development platform of your that you're most comfortable. Some pre-words that this class is not. Okay, we have other classes that cover the other parts. Okay. First, this is, I assume that you have fundamental programming skills. Okay, it's not to teach you how to write fundamental programs. Okay, I assume that you have that already. You are allowed to use any language. Okay, although I will use the GNU C++ in most of my examples. But in your own implementations, you are welcome to use anything you're most comfortable to. Okay, eventually most languages have equivalency anyway. Okay, just a way of convenience. Okay, and techniques like sorting, tree traversing, and things, I assume you already know that. Okay, something that the a data structure course should have covered that, and I assume this is the knowledge you have. With what I said, but we will use a lot of math, but this is not a class to prove convergence or error bounds. Okay, although we will be using some of the theory for testing purposes. Okay, but if you look for, this is not a class that will give you a lot of the math derivation. Okay, we have a lot of good class in the math department for that. And this class is not for internet or cloud computing, not say that it's not important to write a crawler or XML, it's very important. But we have many other classes cover that, so I'll not focus on that at all, okay? And I assume you have some operating system and compiler knowledge, but this is not a class about it. So these are compilers and operating system are introduced in other classes. So I will just briefly use the concept offered by this, without going into the details of those, okay? So the syllabus basically contains two parts. One on the software engineering part, where I will teach you modular programming, regression testing that go with your modular programming, how do you do source code control, okay, in your software evolution, how the source code control can be applied, how memory efficiency can be handled in software. Large-scale software, special techniques to do management. How do you separate different modules, different libraries to be implemented by different team members? What are the techniques for that? That actually associated with the previous four. Okay, large-scale programming have parts in the modular programming. Have how do you write the separate the regression testing? How do you do the source code control? Okay, but I will use example of large-scale software, something like SPICE, okay, for your circuit simulations. I'll introduce what's the principle behind that to manage a large-scale software. You will go through five coding projects, okay, and then these projects, you will have a class presentation, and we'll use the class to get user feedback, okay? So your software is not written for your personal enjoyment. Usually, your software have users. You want to sell it to your customer. You want to do it on the computer to make your information known, okay? So the part, user feedback is very important. We'll conduct it in our lab sections. The other part is the computational engineering. I will introduce the topic that's enough for you to handle the implementation and handle, most importantly, testing, okay? You write something, you always want to know whether it's right or wrong. And this is cannot be done saying the programmer saying that I'm very careful. Not useful, okay? All quality of your software come from testing, just like the quality of anything else, okay? So we'll go for how the computational part that give you the different level of testing. So I'll introduce to you precision and exceptions, local analysis, okay? How do you take derivative or in economies called margin, okay? Do local analysis. I'll show you how to implement sparse matrix so that your computer can handle very big systems. I'll tell you the equivalency of nonlinear solvers and optimizations, okay? The principle behind how to control the error bounds for those. How do you handle geometry by splines, by NURBS, okay? Something we'll introduce in this class so that like in augmented reality, how do you handle the geometry within the computer? And then we'll finally go finish with the ordinary differential equations and partial differential equations. Well, for sure, these are introductions and tell you the main focus will be how do you establish checks and validations within your handling of the ODE and PDE. And especially, how do we do adaptivity? When I have an estimate of the error, how can I adapt my model to the error I have estimated? And we'll contain many of the hacker practice, okay, within class. You'll bring your computer to the class, and then I'll give you assignment that you can observe how the behavior of the software right in class. Okay, and there are many Hack New York, Hack Chicago competitions. So on one side, I hope to train you as a good system, very systematic, large-scale programmer. On the other hand, I think that many times a hacking experience, solving a problem, computational problem in real time is also something I hope to achieve. So in class, we'll have something, a hacker practice like this for the class interactions. And that'll be my introduction of the class.